Welcome back to the Talos Principle. Let's continue on to the first unlocked red puzzle room thing in the tower. And you know what? I never actually looked out from up here before. Damn. Look at this. Can I jump over the edge? Oh god, I think I can. Oh god, okay. Oh. Nothing happened. So there's no such thing as falling damage? Wait a minute. Now I'm down here and the elevator's up there. Can I fall down the shaft? Or is this not gonna open until the elevator... It wouldn't open until the elevator gets here, I guess. But I wonder if there's a way to go down the shaft somehow. I suspect there actually might be a way to do that. I mean, why does the elevator shaft go down so far? Think about that. There was a ton of room down there. It kept going down and down. But this is the first floor I'm able to access. There's more down there. And there was a basement to the elevator on the other side. That's where I came from. So I guess there's a basement to this place too. I bet there's a way to get down there. How would you do that? I have no idea. I mean, I could jump to the top of this building, I suppose. Is there anything up there? I mean, I guess the only way to tell is to actually go, right? Oh, damn it! Thought I had more air control than that. Faster! I'm impatient! Yeah, that keeps going down. Alright, well I'll come back to this jumping thing a little bit later. For now I want to focus on the thing that I was focusing on right when I ended the last episode, and that is this red room. So there is a way to just get inside by going around, but let's just take this at face value and just see how far I can get on this puzzle by just playing within where they seem to expect me to be, which is, you know, inside of this. I guess in other words, I'm going to be coloring within the lines right now, and then afterwards I'll mess everything up. Oh shit, you know what? You know how to get the star, I need a connector? I mean, to get the star in this whole level here, that's hidden in that kind of little back building behind the tower. I need a connector and I need blue power. I probably have to reappropriate one of the connectors from this puzzle to do that. What do you bet? Yeah, I bet you do. Anyway. Alright, so that thing's probably gonna mess me up, right? Oh, so this part of the puzzle is actually completely separate from the other part. So I think you are intended to actually go around the outside and come in from the other end, because it looks like this part of the puzzle is just for doing the blue thing. The blue beam. Because it's all shut off. It's all cut off from the rest of it. Or is it? Oh, never mind, it's not. I spoke too soon. Two connectors, huh? Right, well, two connectors is not enough to wind my way around this. Which is obviously what it's taunting me about, because I'm sure if I just do this, it's not gonna work. Of course not. If I had a connector and brought it up here, I could connect it to there, but I couldn't connect it over there. Unless, no, I don't know. I can't just hit the edge, you have to hit the center of it. And of course there's a little wall here. Lots of things trying to block me. So if I just wanted to connect this, that obviously doesn't help anything. And of course, this doesn't help anything either. So yeah, I can't go through this stuff. I mean, I suppose I could connect from the other end here, but that wouldn't change anything, would it? Well, unless I can lift it up on something. Is there some way for me to jump up on that stuff? Because if I could jump up on there, I could jump maybe up there. It's actually quite likely that there's some way to jump up there. That does not help. Also, I think I'm about to sneeze. I feel it coming. I don't quite know what to do here. If I can get a connector to be here, then I could connect it around that end. Maybe I just need to stop this thing from moving back and forth. How would I do that? I don't have a box, but perhaps the connectors themselves could stop it. So maybe I don't need to use both connectors. Maybe one connector can just be used for stopping that thing. But how would I get it in there? I mean, there's no entrance that I can see. Which means that I suppose I am not intended to. Maybe. Maybe. Alright, we need to try some trickery here. So I want to see two things. One, can I jump onto the walls and make something happen there? And also, can I get up into the rafters? I don't actually see a way. If I could just jump straight over that, like, can I catch onto that lip there in the wall? I have no idea. It might not even have an actual collision mesh. Well, I mean, this does. So maybe the stuff up there does as well. I can't really jump over it well, though. I keep, like, tripping over the railing. Alright, I'm gonna keep working out this puzzle and I'll be right back. Okay, well, I found a way to jump up onto the wall using this right here. There's kind of a little ramp. And this allows me to do many, many things. I think this is the key. Question is though, what exactly do I do? Like, I wonder, if I put one of these really close to the wall, can I grab it from up there? I think it might be too far below me. Yeah, I can't grab it. I don't see anything I could, like, prop it up on or any place on the wall where it's lower where I could, you know, grab it from up here. However, I think I might be able to just, like, jump over the whole thing. Like, okay, I can jump into here, but again, I can't take any of the connectors with me, so what's the point? But. I think I might be able to make that jump. Especially considering I can have a running start here. I think I probably could, but let me just keep looking around. What the hell is that? It's like three dots there. Nah, it's probably nothing. Actually, is that... Oh, that's light, isn't it? Oh yeah, I think it's just light coming in from... Yeah, okay. It's nothing. So I'm just gonna try to make this jump. Well, that wasn't too hard. Now I just need to get this thing open. It knows. What information do you hold for me, sweet forbidden tower? Found one external device. Type device manager to control external devices. External devices. Interesting. Let's do that later. There's a text file on human reproduction. Ew, gross. Athena chapters. Athena Reborn, a novel. Alright, just a table of contents. Let's see if there's anything particularly interesting here. I mean, all of these are things that have been mentioned for the most part in one way or another, like the riddles of the Sphinx, yeah. Hephaestus, the labyrinth, which is pretty much what I'm in. Olympus revealed in the clouds. Am I not traveling into the clouds by going up this forbidden tower? Truth. Do not believe what they are saying. This is not the end of the world created by our Lord GD in 6 days. This is a conspiracy of the government Illuminati and international Darwinism. What? This is a global warming 2.0, a lie told by the children of Beelzebub. Science. Yes, science is Satan. It is literally Satan. Do not let them take your liberty, Exodus 21:24. Defend yourself against all vaccines, experiments, artificial medicines, and popery. Or popery? Is that popery or popery? I don't know. Well, that's a whole load of crazy. Is there some sort of a secret code hidden in the things that are capitalized? Let's look at what's capitalized. So, not believe they, not our Lord, GD. No, there's nothing. Human reproduction. Surely if a machine is able to reproduce another machine systematically, we may say that it has a reproductive system. And how few of the machines are there which have not been produced systematically by other machines? But it is man that makes them do so. Yes, but is it not insects that make many of the plants reproduce? And would not whole families of plants die out if their fertilization was not affected by a class of agents utterly foreign to themselves? Each one of ourselves has sprung from minute animalcules? I'm not sure how to pronounce that, whose entity was entirely distinct from our own, and which acted after their kind with no thought or heed of what we might think about it. These little creatures are part of our own reproductive system. Then why not we part of that of the machines? That's quite interesting. That is actually very true. Insects make plants happen, for the most part. Humans make robots reproduce. That is true. How do you pronounce that? It's not that it's like particularly a hard arrangement of words, or letters I mean, but I mean animal, that's the first part, animal, and then cules. But then when you put them together, how's it pronounced? Animalcules? Animalcules? Culus? I don't know. It's a weird one. Anyway, what is this device manager? Elevator controller! I was just thinking about the elevator a second ago and how I might be able to do something with it. And how there might be something below it, and how if I could fall down that shaft, I would be able to survive because I know there's no fall damage. Elevator security configuration. Alright, show me the current parameters. It's even got a serial number. Main Nexus elevator, 7 floors. 1 shaft. That'd be a nice name for a porno. 7 floors, 1 shaft. Software license is free, evaluation expired. you're breaking copyright. Security levels FAC, whatever that means. Authorization mode code. Anyway, hold on, I'm actually going to write that down, 7 floors. Because I want to see how many floors are actually listed on the panel, because if those disagree, then something's going on. Floor access control, auxiliary stairway access control, exit this utility. Floor access control. You are currently on floor 1. Oh, so it looks like I can unlock floor number 2 from here without requiring a code, but the other ones need codes. Alright, well I guess I might as well just unlock floor 2. Currently locked, would you like to unlock it? Yes, please. Unlocking. Unlocked, so if I wanted to go back and lock one, I could. I don't see any reason to do that at the moment, so let's just leave that. So if I tried to unlock floor number 3, what would it say? Ah, So at this point, it's not giving me a multiple choice thing. In other words, this is actually very important to note, because there's this kind of awkwardness that sometimes comes about when you learn passwords. Because sometimes you need to make your character learn the code. Like, it's an option that will pop up from your list of options, and it will only pop up in that list if you make your character aware of the code. But if you do it a different way like this, where you can just enter whatever code you want, then you truly have to just know it yourself. In other words, I might know the code already, but I just don't know what it is, if that makes sense. Because, I mean, I've found lots of weird stuff. Like, I've written down serial numbers that I've found on statues and all sorts of strange stuff. It is important to note, though, it is numbers, not letters. So, for example, I found a bunch of letters that seemed to spell out somebody's name back a while ago. That was the one that said, what did it say? Hold on, I actually have it out here. It was back in episode 7 when I found the letters that were S-Y-R-O-A-K-K-V, which, as somebody in the comments told me, is most likely referring to, if you rearrange it, it can say Rakowski, which I believe is one of the people that actually worked on this place. So if I check that, let's actually check the team leads. Yes. So those letters were most likely referring to Bob Rakowski. Rakowski, who worked on the simulation module. So I have stuff like that, but I can't really turn that into numbers, so I don't think that's relevant to this. Let me see how many numbers it wants. Oh, I guess you don't know how many it wants, do you? Well, the max is 8, but that doesn't necessarily mean that it takes 8. It could be less than 8. Oh! Jesus Christ! 2 more tries left. I didn't realize there was a limited number of tries. Cancel! Shit. I better be pretty sure about that next time I try. I better be really sure. Alright, so let's try auxiliary stairway access control. Let's see what that is. Your software license has expired. The auxiliary stairway is in always open mode now. Please renew your license to enable auxiliary stairway locking. Oh my god, it's been so long that the auxiliary stairway is always open. What is the auxiliary stairway, though? What is that referring to? I mean, auxiliary suggests an additional thing. Like a backup. Like a backup to the elevator, and it says it's in always open mode. So does that mean if I somehow find this or activate this backup that I can just go to any floor I want without using the elevator? That's what it seems to suggest. I mean, the authorization mode is in code, so perhaps I could even change that itself to not require a code. I don't think there's anything else I can do here, though. Alright. Where does that leave me? That leaves me wanting to free these connectors from this puzzle room. Because I have two connectors here and I didn't even use them. I wonder if this is where I need to get my blue power to get the star. Maybe it's not from the place behind the wood. Maybe the place behind the wood is just a tease. And I can't ever unlock that. Maybe this is where I need to actually get it from. But if I wanted... Is there like a window to the outside? I mean, if I wanted to get these damn connectors out, how would I do it? I can jump up on the wall, but how can I pick them up from the wall? There's nothing to prop them up on. I don't know, there's something more going on here. There's definitely something more going on here. Well, I mean, wait a minute. I just realized it's not even a challenge to get these things out. I can just take them out. So that's not the issue. Maybe I could have solved it this way. It doesn't really matter anymore, but... I might have been able to. Maybe. Like, I could have put that right there, and then... Where would the other one go? Well, I don't know. Well, regardless, I can do this. Which means I could get the blue power out here. But then connect to what? Where's my auxiliary access? I don't know. I mean, I could actually just put it here and then try to connect to it from down there if I had another connector, which I don't. Hell if I know. I'm gonna try jumping on this again. Whee! Alright, let's see if there's anything up here. Any floppy disks? I wonder if I could, like, beam some energy to a satellite or something. Don't think it works that way. Ooh, can I fall down the shaft? Can I jump in between? I could fit between there. Damn you. I know you can fit, you bastard. Just crawl. Crawl. Nah, that's not gonna happen. I mean, that's not like an elevator, is it? I mean, elevator, that... this is an elevator, I mean, that's not a ladder, is it? I think that's just... no, that's just the track that the elevator travels on. Alright, let's go to floor number two.
Thank you.
Seems Elohim lacks the power to stop me from climbing this thing. No doubt he still has some tricks up his sleeve. Do I have enough red to open this? No. Nope, need 5 more. I want out there. I'm trying to bash it down with my head, as if that's going to do something. Alright, I think we're done with the tower for now. I'm not sure if I've read these before. I can't remember. I don't think I have. On returning from the tower, I feel a great tiredness and an enormous energy. What I now know disturbs me, but I hope that by living with this knowledge, I might provide a shoulder for you, the giants of tomorrow.
Where have you been, child? Remember, the Great Tower is not for you. Do not give up the hope of eternal life for the hollow promises of curiosity.
Beep boop. There's something new in the computer. Oh, you are just my favorite person today. You've been exploring that fancy pants tower of his, haven't you? I just love it when he doesn't get his way. What did you see? Just more puzzles. Figures. And did you get in trouble? Tell me. Did he even notice? It sounds like he didn't actually know where I was. It was suggestive that he suspected I was in the tower, but he never actually specifically said it. Not yet. I'm not surprised. Needless to say, I think you can afford to push a little further before risking anyone's wrath. Of course, it's entirely up to you, isn't it? And then just ended. Okay, who was talking to me? Who the hell was I just conversing with? Is that the entity from the archives that I've heard mentioned before? Alright. It's time to move into a land of pure red puzzles. Wait a minute, this is not the right one, is it? Nope. Oh, this is the one. Okay, yeah. So that's not pure red puzzles. I think this is the largest grid I've ever had to assemble. Let's just start putting some stuff. Well, that wasn't hard. Now I'm very suspicious of the rafters. Does that mean anything? That there's like a scratch on the ground? Most likely not. This whole place seems to be kind of... well, not exactly falling apart, but... not exactly the best maintained building. I have seen the truth. Only Elohim can save us from eternal oblivion. It's a small-ass door. Alright, can I get into the rafters? Not that I can see, and I don't see any reason to either. Is there something up there? Doesn't seem to be. Don't see a floppy disk or anything like that. Oh, all the puzzles are in the basement.
A new land stands before you, my child. And know that this is a land of death, but also great beauty. As you walk amongst these tombs, consider all those who came before you, and how they served the greater purpose of which you are also part.
Oh my God. This is gorgeous. Well, I guess this is probably where the riddle of the Sphinx will come up. I bet Croteam were right at home, making Egyptian-themed stuff. Given all their experience with that with Sirius Sam. This is so cool. Is there something up there? It's a little alcove. This place is just gorgeous. Oh, this is another star room. Look at that. This one probably requires even more stars. Actually, no, this requires the same amount. 10. Let's just get a feel for this place. Ah, so there's the fan, which I do not have all the parts for yet. There's another thing, what is that? What is that? Play... I think that might be a recorder. I remember seeing in that little weird place that had all the other versions of me and stuff like that. I remember seeing somebody with a camera and somebody like replaying their actions. It didn't exactly look like that. Well, maybe it did, but it was just bigger. I'm not sure. Yeah, it's got the play button on it, so that probably is it. I have no idea what that's going to do to the gameplay. It's going to be strange. Phew. pure yellow, mostly yellow. And this one already requires the fan. Let's see if there's any abnormalities with this place. Any missing secret doorways. Three, two, one. Okay, it's perfectly normal. There's the star room. Oh, one's boarded over. Could I perhaps fit over that? Maybe. You know what? Okay. This is something I've been thinking about for this entire episode, but I haven't tested it until now. There's something I want to try. Okay, so this is boarded over by, well, boards. My first thought is I need to break it. So how would I do that? Well, it'd be nice if I could, like, punch or have a weapon or something, but that doesn't seem to be something that's going to happen. So here's something else I was thinking. It's really dumb and it's probably not going to work, but what if I can break it by just running into it really fast? Hey, it's worth a shot, right? I mean, I can run really freaking fast. What if I run from the absolute opposite side? I mean, I'm not really gaining speed, so I don't think it's gonna do anything. But just in case. Come on. Ah, fuck you. I would've felt so clever if that worked. Now I just feel like a robot who ran into a wall. Okay, I think I've scouted this place out well enough. Let's go to world number one. Oh my god. God, this game is so cool. The sudden change in locale is just really refreshing. And I'm sure the puzzles are gonna get a lot harder from here on out. I'm finally getting some sense out of the entity in the archive. Though at some cost to my sanity. I am beginning to think this Elohim wields no more control over the world than we do. Okay, yeah, so what I was conversing with on the computer, that was the what is referred to as the entity in the archive. But Elohim is supposed to be basically a dungeon master, right? Crafting the experience? What if he himself is playing the role of the entity in the archive to give me an interesting experience? What if he's doing that on purpose? What if he's playing multiple roles? The role of the guy who's telling you what to do, and then the role of the person who's mysteriously saying that, hey, maybe you don't have to do what he says. Osiris. Original translation by E.A. Wallace Budge. Annotation by something. The dying man went unto the scribe who resided in some, what, Permajid? And said, behold, I am weak of body. My days under the holy sun of Amun-Ra are coming to an end. Though I have spent my years in service of the two lands, I have not studied the... Tell me, you who are wise in the writings of the dead, what lies ahead on my journey? What will I face in the land of the Westerners? And the scribe spoke, saying, at the appointed time... Hold on, is there something that I could translate into hexadecimal? I only see a 3 and a 7. Those are the only possible values. Nah, probably not. Oh, and then these are just like little footnotes. So for one, resided in Per Majed, it is likely the location was changed according to who the copy of the book was made for. The dying man is an avatar of the owner. Number two, Amun-Ra. In the older manuscript, this is rendered as some controversy as to whether it... it just stops. Three is the land of the Westerners. The dead. Compare with Kenti Amentu, the foremost of the Westerners, a title later given to Osiris. And then number five, which isn't even on here. Sometimes mistaken for a mistranslation on Budge's part, this is actually almost certainly a mistranslation by the ancient scribe. The equivalent portion of the older manuscript is sadly not extant. Could be some important information in there, although I can't make sense of it at the moment. Immortality. Wait, is this a blog post? Disgruntlemeister's Blockstasy, episode 204. I don't know about everybody else, but I'm afraid of dying. I don't see any reason to believe there's an afterlife. I'm an organism like any other. When my brain stops working, my consciousness will cease, and I will be gone. And you know what? I can't just embrace that. I can't say I'm okay with it, or I've accepted it, or some nonsense like that. I don't want to have an ending. It terrifies me. If I had a genie right now, I'd wish for immortality. Who wouldn't? Oh, but you wouldn't really want to be immortal, the pseudo-philosophers say. Pretentious drivel. Everybody wants to live forever. Maybe everybody deserves to live forever, too. But we can't. So here we are. Live with it. Or rather, don't. Got It Lyrics. 24 million views. Cannot load video file. My new song with lyrics. Gotta laugh about this stuff. Laughter is the best medicine. Lol. I've got it, you've got it, he's got it, she's got it. Mom, what the fuck is this? And the chorus is, of course, everybody's got it. And then the chorus turns into dogs. And then there's a dancing dog. Oh my god. No, just, no. Okay, well, before I venture forth into this majestic beauty, I think I will end this episode here. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.